Hello, this is Leilani with Adobe Analytics Product Management. In this video, I'm going to share with you a new feature available in Analysis Workspace for our streaming media analytics customers, the Media Concurrent Viewers panel. This new feature enables you to understand where peak concurrency occurred or where drop-offs happened to provide valuable insight into the quality of content and viewer engagement, and to help with troubleshooting or planning for volume and scale. To use the panel, first create a new project. Be sure that your report suite is set to one that's enabled for streaming media analytics. In the left rail panel menu, drag the Media Concurrent Viewers panel into your project. You'll see that the panel builder has a few default settings. The date range is set to today, and the granularity is set to minute. And the panel summary numbers is set to maximum only. If you change nothing and click build, you'll get a visualization with data up to the current time today, but I'm going to select another day just to get a full day of data. Now in the panel, you'll have a line chart that shows concurrent viewers for each minute of the day. And as with any line chart in Analysis Workspace, you can hover over to see the details. You can also see the peak concurrent viewer time called out in both the line chart and the summary number below. You will notice that this panel does not include a freeform table for the data source. If you do want to see the data for each minute in a table, you can right-click on the panel visualization and download to CSV. Then you'll get all 1440 rows, which is 24 hours at a minute level granularity. In this panel, you can apply a segment and/or series breakdowns. Segments can be applied as usual by dropping a segment component. For this example, I'm going to show you how to add breakdowns. You can do this when you first build the panel, or to edit, click on the pencil icon to the right to bring up the panel builder. For series breakdowns, you can add dimensions, dimension items, segments, or date ranges for comparison. I'm going to break this one down by mobile device type. There is a limit of 10 breakdowns. If you choose a dimension that has more than 10 values, then the dimension items populated will be the top 10 for the panel date range. As you can see on here, I have populated 8 of the 10. Once the panel is rebuilt, you'll see that I have concurrent viewers broken down by mobile device type on my line chart. In addition, there is a peak concurrency summary number for each breakdown included. Another thing that you can do is use the series breakdowns to compare between two date ranges. I'm going to edit this panel and compare yesterday to today. When using date ranges for series breakdowns, they'll override the panel date range. Now, an important thing to call out is that this visualization is limited to a data source of 1440 rows. So with a granularity of minute, you are limited to one day of data. You can, however, analyze more than one day at a time. When you choose a larger date range, the granularity will be automatically updated to the lowest level available. So I'm going to show you this in a new panel, actually, and pick a date range of the last 3 months. When I use a date range of 3 months, the lowest granularity available is day. You'll get a reminder here that you can close and then build the panel. Once the panel is built, it will show you the granularity that is used in the summary at the top. And you'll see that in this visualization, the peak day in the last 3 months was Wednesday, July 22nd. So what does it mean when we're talking about concurrent viewers for a time range that is not a minute? So basically, if we're talking about for an hour, it's the sum of the unique concurrent viewers for all minutes within the hour. For the day, it'll be the sum of concurrent viewers for all minutes within that day. If I want to drill down now to see where the peak concurrency happened on July 22nd, then I can go ahead and update the panel to pick that day. And when I change the date range, it will also automatically update to the lowest granularity available. Now, because I picked one day, then it changes it to minute. Again, you'll get a reminder that that's happening here and you can close it to rebuild it. But just since I changed the date range, I don't have to rebuild. So now you'll see that the granularity has been updated to minute. But if you do actually just want to see the peak hour, etc., then you can edit the panel and then select a higher granularity if you want. Finally, if you still want to get data, at minute level granularity for a larger date range that is available now via the Analytics Reporting API 2.0 for up to 1 month at a time. And you can check our documentation for more information. And there you have it, Media Concurrent Viewers in Analysis Workspace.